this big wig at me. He told me I'd never eat lunch in this town again. And I said, hey, if I'm in town, I'm eating lunch, baby.
Oh, no. No, no, no. I don't have spider bites over half my body, so you two could fake another injury. Nice try.
Ooh, I bet that hurts. Happy St. Patrick's Day! Guinness and Irish cream cupcakes for everyone. Enjoy your blackout. These are the last 12 cupcakes. Actually, two of them are just potatoes from the diner. At some point, I started putting green icing on anything I could find. Max, we haven't been so busy since someone spray-painted free sex stuff on the wall outside. And you said I'm not good at marketing.
Happy St. Patrick's Day.
Bridget, Patrick, John, Mary, and you, the little one, come over here.
We're here to pick up our order?
Should be here to pick up birth control. Coming right up, Max.
Ridiculousness. I'm Rob Dyrdek. With me, as always, Chanel West Coast and Steve Lovegren. I'm not even messing around anymore, you know what I mean?
What does that mean?
Because we've done so many episodes, I don't know why I even chose you first. Are you mad that I choose him first all this time? Or you ever thought, like, man, that's kind of crazy?
I've never thought about it till now.
I mean, I think it's because it's left-right, which is pretty
yeah,
normal.
Okay, there's never been a method to me, right? Let me ask you this. Did you guys go to prom?
Yeah, I went to two.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Tell me about it. What? You got all soft and swaggy on that one. Yeah, actually, I went to two.
We'll take it.
Confidence is a preference for the habitual voyeur of what is known as. A morning suit can be avoided if you take a route straight through what is known as.
Two, three, push!
But, Dad, I'm out of breath.
Yeah, well, I told you not to smoke.
I thought you just meant crack.
No, I meant cigarettes too. At your age, you should just be vaping. Push!
Where's Mum?
She's still in the furniture store.
Hey, Dad, let's put it in here.
No, that is my brother's room.
But, Dad, he's been missing for 28 years. We need the room. There's 9 of us.
No, I'm keeping it the way he likes it. Although when he comes back, I will have to break it to him that some of his childhood heroes didn't love women as much as we thought they did. And one of them liked them a little too much.
It was a little strange, including myself. Sometimes I would bring my son into work, and Bill would let my son play games on his phone. About a week before the allegations came out and Bill got arrested, I found out that Bill was texting my son. My son said he had been messaging him for a couple of months. When I saw the messages, I was instantly sick to my stomach. I was mad, I was infuriated. Bill was always telling my son they were always gonna be friends, they were buddies. In some of the texts, Bill was telling my son that he was going to buy him a new iPhone. A week after finding the messages on my son's phone, I found out that Bill was being accused of molesting his own grandson. When the allegation surfaced, it was a total aha moment for me. I believe that Bill is 100% a child molester. If I could talk to Bill, I would say, You make me sick. And I hope that you end up spending the rest of your life in prison.
Well, Kathy, I appreciate your willingness to be here. You found some information on your son's cell phone. That's what correct. Did you see? What did you find?
I found messages from Bill. No sexual messages. Messages that there were probably 15 messages over the course of approximately 2 weeks. They basically just said he was going to try and buy him a new iPhone. They were always going to be buddies. They should get together and play video games. If he had any games on his phone that my son wanted to download, just to let him know, stuff like that. But it made me sick, instantly sick. Mom's intuition, whatever. I immediately deleted the messages, blocked his number from being able to call or text my son's phone, yanked my son into the room, asked him, you know, my son was, of course, dumbfounded. He didn't, at 12, he wasn't thinking anything. Like, what, Mom, you know?
Bill, what do you say about that?
I believe Kathy's a joke. She's Cindy's best friend, and she's apparently got issues. The thing is, if that was true, you don't text somebody and then delete their messages. You use it for evidence, and it still can be retrieved. So just because she thinks that she deleted it, there's still retrieval methods and procedures. So she could talk all the talk she wants. She can bash me all she wants. She's a bold-faced liar, and nobody in the community likes her. She has no friends.
Stop. Before we assassinate her character, let me just ask you, did you know this young man?
Sir?
Did you text him?
I don't know. Never. No, sir. No, I might have texted him while I was in a stand around her mom and dad, like once. I do remember once when...
Natural lubricant?
Like a hot dog in a buttered bun.
Oh, yeah, like this, see?
Give me my hot dog.
Weird metaphor.
Now, circumcision has been found to reduce the rate of HIV acquisition in men by up to 60%, but condoms reduce it by 80%, and they don't require you to, cut your dong off. Oh, hey, this is your place.
Okay, but girls think uncut dongs look weird.
Interesting theory. Let's test it. Excuse me, miss. Does this dong look weird?
Yep.
And does this dong look weird?
Yep.
All right, and does this dong look weird?
Yep, all dongs look weird.
Oh, hey, Haley, hi.
Hey, guys.
Oh, hold on 1 second, I'll be right down.
Hey, Adam, ruining something?
Yep, just telling Murph about circumcision, the old circumciz. See, back in the Victorian era.
Another time. I'm running late for this boozy painting.
My goodness gracious.
Did she get
pizza?
Oh, what? You're mad that we didn't save any slices for you? Well, hopefully next time, Bumbles will be more thoughtful and buy enough for everyone.
Oh. Yeah, free skate! Who wants to race?
Grab a partner, folks! It's time for couple skate!
Wait, what? Isn't this fun, Lynn?
So fun.
Hey! Oh, why does that kid get to have all the fun?
Love doves prefer to let their prey marinate in fear first.
Oh, can it, Planta? This is all your fault. If you taught your grandson proper courtship technique...
My fault? It's obviously yours.
Guys, it says here that our relationships define us and nothing else.
Nothing else?
Of course, I find people believe that 8 out of 9 people are unhappy and 6 out of 7 believe...
It's all your fault!
Say what?
No, impossible.
Zip it! The only reason we're here marinating is because you all had to play matchmaker. You two were greedy. Plain and simple.
Maybe a little.
It's nuanced.
Nice. Totally innocent for once. You two should be ashamed.
Are you kidding? Sprinkle.
This is Dewberry from the new Coolsville Library Book Patrol. Uh-oh, Mrs. Shushman, you tore a page in your book.
That's no excuse.
Like you better pay before Mrs. Dewberry has to take away your library card.
Oh, bless me.
All right, I'll take care of it. Return my book to my library before midnight, or else.
What, did you hear that, Scoob?
We're gone. History, heading for that big pizza parlor in the sky.
I heard.
What book is the ghost talking about?
It happened a long time ago.
Thanks for the book, Mrs. Shushman.
Shh! No talking in the library.
Okay.
No puppy slurping allowed in the library.
Sheesh, what a rout.
But one day, when I ran inside to get a snack, Scooby accidentally buried the book in the backyard. And then they closed down the old library, so I never could return the book.
Oh, you two. Why would a ghost librarian want that book?
Like Pizza Parrot meets the Butter Bean Bunnies is a classic.
Yeah, it's the greatest.